a gallery here in town, and the mobiles used to trip the security system. So I decided I'd make paintings of them and they wouldn't move, and trip the security system. So this is the last one in that series. I have like a couple of dozen others in that series. And this one is called Dancing Mobile. And it's done pretty monochromatically. It's done with Payne's Gray, the color Payne's Gray. And if you know anything about the mixing of Payne's Gray, it's made with ultramarine and the yellow. So it's not exactly black. So it has a little color in there too, which adds a little bit, I think. So anyone wants to know?
So tell us about the motivation for making the work. Are you working as a professional artist, or are you?
Well, I'm not really professional, though I do make some money at it. There's a gallery down in North Hollywood that rents pieces to the studios in Hollywood for set design. And I worked, this piece was the biggest money maker I've had with them. It made some headway in my financial consideration. And if you want to see other works in this series, under artpic.com, artpic.com, there are all the artists represented by this woman who has her gallery.
I'm curious to know about the negative space in this. I'd love to see more of the action happening in less of the negative space, but I'm curious why that you took that route with it. All the canvas isn't painted all the way to the edge.
Well, I don't know, it's something I haven't considered. I think these little lines that are spilled out from the main part of the drawing or the painting develop those spaces a little bit. I don't know.
I can see why this would be super successful in film and television because of the contrast in it would translate really well.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I think are they all this contrasty, like this kind of white, dark, black and white?
Some of them are colors. One is all white with the shapes poking out with color of the white.